Now look, we have refused to be addressed by Mr. Jacob Zuma because he's an illegitimate president of South Africa. Under normal circumstances, under strict application of the rules of parliament, he was supposed to be in a process now to account on why did he violate the constitution, because the constitutional court is categorically clear that Jacob Zuma has violated the constitution. And we go on as parliament as if everything else is normal. So we're making a point in parliament that we cannot allow to be addressed by a person who has been found to have violated the oath of office, because the constitutional court ruling clearly states that he has violated the oath of office. And we cannot just sit back as parliament as if everything else is normal. And the ANC is abusing its majoritarian position to undermine the constitution. We're not in a majoritarian parliament. We're not in a majoritarian constitution. We are in a constitution that is guided by the rule of law. You cannot use the majority to undermine what has been agreed to be the principles and core values of our system of democracy. So we cannot allow Jacob Zuma to continue as if everything is normal. We have written to the speaker. She kept a very long time without responding to us. She only sent us a response this morning because Jacob Zuma is coming here, because she knows that even when we go to court ultimately, Jacob Zuma has to be subjected to a process. Parliament is the institution that must hold Jacob Zuma accountable. And he has been found to have acted outside the law, and Parliament is not doing anything about it. That is the message that we are sending. We'll never allow to be addressed by a criminal. We'll never allow to give money, a budget, to a criminal who is just going to abuse that money for his own self-enrichment and promotion of his family. We cannot allow that to happen. We are a country that has been in a difficult situation before, where individuals were more important than institutions. South Africa cannot go back to the dark ages of repression, of violence, of people who do not want the rule of law to be the order of the day. That is the message that we are sending to the people of South Africa, that let us change these people when we come to the local government elections. The EFF is the only option that will save what is left of South Africa today, because what we have now is just not what those who fought for democracy in a real sense envisaged and wanted to achieve.